बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आवर नेक्स्ट मॉड्यूल, मॉड्यूल नंबर MECH अंडरस्कोर पी अंडरस्कोर 022 अंडरस्कोर रेमोंड सर्वे जॉन ज्यूट। स्टेटमेंट, एज्यूम इट टेक्स 7.00 मिनट्स टू फिल ए 30.0 गैलन गैसोलीन टैंक। प्रॉब्लम है थ्री पार्ट्स, ओके। पार्ट ए, कैलकुलेट द रेट एट विच द टैंक इज फिल्ड इन गैलन्स पर सेकेंड। पार्ट बी, कैलकुलेट द रेट एट विच द टैंक इज फिल्ड इन क्यूबिक मीटर्स पर सेकेंड। पार्ट सी, डिटरमिन द टाइम इंटरवल इन आवर्स रिक्वायर्ड टू फिल ए 1.00 क्यूबिक मीटर वॉल्यूम एट द सेम रेट। Within bracket, hint is given, one United States gallon is equal to 231 inch cubic inch, okay? This fact has been taken from table of conversion factors, okay? Now we move on to next slide. Solution. We have to use the following conversion factors. 1 minute equal to 60 seconds. 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. 1 gallon is equal to 231 cubic inch. 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 10 raised to the power 2 centimeter, that is 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Okay, next slide. Solution of part A. Hence, rate in gallon per second is equal to 30.0 divided by 7 into 60, because 7 are minutes, but we have to give answer in seconds, so we will multiply it with 60, okay? Rate in gallon per second is equal to 30.0 divided by 7 into 60 gallon per second. This is alternatively equal to 0.07142857 gallon per second. Dear students, this can alternatively be written as equal to 7.14 into 10 raised to the power minus 2 gallon per second. It can also be written equal to 714 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 gallon per second. It can also be written equal to 7140 into 10 raised to the power minus 5 gallon per second. Okay. It does not make any difference, okay? All these three answers are 100% correct, okay? Now we move on to part B. Part B, rate in cubic meter per second is equal to, which we have already calculated in part A, okay? 7.14 into 10 raised to the power minus 2 multiplied by 231, because in part A we had calculated in gallon, but here we have to convert it in cubic meter. For converting into cubic meter, we will first convert it into inch, and inch will be converted into centimeter, and then centimeters will be converted into meters. Okay. And when we are calculating cubic meter, so the value of meter, okay, dear students, here gallons have been converted into inches by multiplying with 231, and this is again multiplied with 0.0254. Okay, this is when we convert inch into centimeter and then centimeter into meter. In other words, directly inch into meter. So we have used this conversion factor, 7.14 into 10 raised to the power of minus 2 was given in the previous slide as a solution to part A. Here we have made changes. We have multiplied it with 231 because we are not here concerned with gallons. We are concerned with cubic meter. So we have first converted it into inches and then inches into meters. Okay, 7.14 into 10 raised to the power minus 2 into 231 into 0.0254 cube, and its units are cubic meter over second. This will be alternatively equal to 0.0027 cubic meter over second. Okay, this is the answer of our part B. Okay, this is 100% correct. 0.00027 cubic meter over second. However, in the next step, we have converted into some different shape. Okay, just for our convenience, or just to make our answer slightly beautiful. Okay, so we have converted 0.00027 cubic meter over second equal to 27 into 10 raised to the power minus 5 cubic meter over second. This can again be written equal to 2.7 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 cubic meter over second. Okay, it can further be transformed into one or two more different shapes. Okay, but all these three answers are 100% correct. Okay, now we move on to part C, which is relatively difficult, complicated. However, we deal it according to our understanding. Okay, there may be some minor irregularity in explaining part C because it is not so simple. Okay, however, we try to solve it as per our understanding. Okay, part C, we have already calculated rate, volume per second. Okay, in part B, this rate is in cubic meter over second. Cubic meter is volume, second is time. So this rate is in volume per time, volume per second. But now we require rate time per volume. Okay, this is the Main point involved in this part C. We have already calculated rate volume per second, but now we require rate time per volume. For this purpose, we proceed as under. What as under? This will be shown in the next slide. Okay. Rate volume per time is 2.7 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 cubic meter over second. Now rate time per volume, meaning inverse of the above figure. So it will be equal to, it will be equivalent to 2.7 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 raised to the power minus 1. Okay, because we are reversing the above figure, we are taking the reciprocal of the above figure, above expression. So 2.7 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 will be raised to minus 1 power. Okay. The remaining portion, second, will become on upper side and cubic meter will become on the lower side. Okay. Because we are taking reciprocal of the above expression. Okay. So I hope up to this it is quite okay. Now further we will use these two conversion factors. Cubic meter will be taken as one, because as per requirement we have to calculate the rate per 1 cubic meter. Okay, so in place of m raised to the power 3 cubic meter, there will become 1. And we know that 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. This implies that 1 second will become equal to 1 over 3600 hour. So rate time per volume will become 2.7 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 raised to the power minus 1 into 1 over 3600 hour over 1. Okay. So here, dear students, we have used the value of second in hour, while we have used the value of cubic meter equal to 1 as per requirement. So this implies that 1 over 3600 into 10 raised to the power 4 divided by 2.7 hour. Dear students, because 2.7 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 has its power minus 1. So 10 raised to the power minus 1 raised to the power minus 1 will become plus 4. Okay. That is why 10 raised to the power plus 4 has become upper and 2.7 has become on the lower side, because 2.7 has power minus 1. Okay. So almost it does not need to be explained in detail. Oh, we are not students of matric or FSC. Okay. So this is equal to 1.0288 hour. This is equivalently equal to 1.03 hour. Now there is no need to explain why we have written 1.0288 hour as equal to or equivalent to 1.03 hour, because we have worked enough on this minor approximate conversion. Okay. Hence, time required to fill a 1.00 cubic meter tank is equal to 1.03 hour, and this is the answer of our part C, which was relatively complicated. Dear students, in this module we have not added additional note because the problem is already enough lengthy and to some extent complicated. Okay, and I think no new conversion factor is used in this module, because in our all the 22 modules we are dealing with conversion factors. So this is just a practice of our previous trend. Okay, so I think this is enough for this module. Okay, Allah Hafiz.